Captain Paul Lanzalota, who took command of the carrier in February, told reporters in an August 9 phone call there were no fires or floods, no significant injuries, and no reports of marine mammal impacts. I definitely know that we have added items to our planned incremental availability maintenance period. However, we actually planned for that, and nothing that I've seen reported to me so far is in the category of so much more work that it's expected to add to the scope of the availability in terms of schedule, he said. We did have some things break, and we will fix them, Lanzalota added. Rear Admiral Jim Downey, the program executive officer for aircraft carriers, said the Navy originally predicted more work would be required following the string of live blasts, and that the maintenance period at Newport News Shipbuilding would take longer. Those predictions were based on what happened during the last carrier shock trial in 1987 involving the Nimitz-class carrier Theodore Roosevelt. Upon closer review, though, Downey said the projections for required work were reduced by about 50% in 2019, and after the second blast on July 16, the carrier was improving on those revised projections. It will still take a few days to fully inspect and stress the carrier. But Downey told reporters, "We appear to be well within the projected scope of the maintenance period." He added that most of the items on the ship that broke were not items required to be shock-hardened. Though Downey and Lanzalota didn't provide a list of those items, typically, hull and combat systems are shock-hardened, while items related to office and living spaces aren't. Downey noted that only about 5% of the work completed during the upcoming maintenance period will be related to fixing items that broke during shock trials. The rest will be modernizing the ship to get it ready for high-end operations during its maiden deployment, anticipated in late 2022. During shock trials, a small boat tows a 40,000-pound explosive behind it in the water. The Navy has marine mammal search teams ensuring that, though the times and locations of shock trials are planned around known migration patterns, no protected animals are in the vicinity. Once the go has been given, the blast detonates farther from the ship during the first event, and then successively closer each time, and the crew of about 3,000 braces for impact. After the blast, the crew conducts damage control, looking for any signs of floods or fires, and checking combat and ship systems to ensure anything that went offline is quickly restored. Lanzalota said helicopters were landing on the carrier within minutes of the blast, showing that the ship was still in fighting condition. From here, he said, the crew will spend the next few days carefully examining systems and subsystems to ensure it has caught all the damage, and then we'll put the ship through its paces to ensure nothing else pops up when the carrier zooms back towards Virginia at 40 knots. Sometimes we can take damage and not notice it immediately, because it's kind of something that's latent, Lanzalota said. So we'll be doing the full high-speed runs here within a couple of days, but in the meantime we're going inch by inch, stem to stern on the ship to make sure that we've inspected her properly and don't aggravate anything that the giant bomb, that charge that was off the side of the ship, did yesterday, he added.